Thanks for joining us. I'm Christy Casciano.
I'm Jeff Kulikowski, and we continue tonight to follow the breaking news that Congressman John Katko is planning to vote to impeach President Trump. News Channel 9's Andrew Donovan following it for us. He joins us now live. Andrew, what more have you learned since we broke this at 5 tonight?
Well, Jeff, we have the statement from Congressman Katko in which he defends this decision. For context, remember, Congressman Katko calls the previous impeachment of the president as ridiculous. He told us that last week. So this clearly shows why this second impeachment has more meat to it, which is what Congressman Katko expected. He says he's going to treat this decision like a former prosecutor looking at the facts. And the facts, according to his statement, is that a mob intended to disrupt a joint session of Congress did so violently, talking about how Capitol Police were overrun and how insurrectionists stormed and vandalized the Capitol. For the staff and police officers who were in the Capitol that day, Katko says this event will forever haunt them. Therefore, here is where Congressman Katko lays it out explicitly. Quote, it cannot be ignored that President Trump encouraged this insurrection, both on social media ahead of January 6th and in his speech that day, by deliberately promoting baseless theories suggesting the election was somehow stolen. The president created a combustible environment of misinformation, disenfranchisement, and division. When this manifested in violent acts on January 6th, he refused to promptly and forcefully call it off, putting countless lives in danger. The congressman's statement goes on from there. We will have it posted to localsyr.com as long as our digital team can get it up and type quickly. It'll be there ASAP. John Katko, though, goes on to talk about how other Republicans might not agree with his decision. And he talks about, I hear my Republican colleagues and their argument about this further dividing the country. But Katko says, I also believe firmly that I must follow the law and the facts and hold this president accountable. Katko laying it out there, saying this president broke the law, and now he plans to hold the president accountable through a vote of impeachment, which we expect to happen tomorrow on the House floor. Live in Syracuse, Andrew Donovan, News Channel 9.